IVF is the most successful fertility treatment available today. Despite that fact, many embryos which are transferred into the uterus will fail to implant. Some scientists believe that some of these failed implantations may be due to problems with a patient's immune system. Some doctors have used a potent medication to suppress the immune system at the time of an embryo transfer. Does this improve the IVF success rate? Stay tuned. Prednisone belongs to a class of drugs known as corticosteroids. Corticosteroids suppress the immune system in a number of different ways and are also known to reduce inflammation in the body. In the past, some IVF doctors have used prednisone in an attempt to improve IVF success rates. However, the scientific studies that were conducted using prednisone in IVF cycles have not been very good. Recently, a very well-done study was published that tried to answer the question of whether prednisone was an effective treatment for patients who had a history of recurrent IVF implantation failure. For this study, patients were recruited who had undergone two or more embryo transfer cycles with good quality embryos but did not achieve a clinical pregnancy. On average, recruited patients had three failed transfers. The patients must also be planning to do a frozen embryo transfer and have one or more good quality embryos to use. To prepare the uterus for a frozen embryo transfer, all patients took estrogen to thicken the uterine lining, followed by progesterone to prepare the lining for implantation. These are routine medications that are given to patients who are attempting pregnancy with frozen embryos. However, for this study, the patients were split into two groups. Group 1 received prednisone twice a day, every day, at the same time that they started taking estrogen. Group 2 took a placebo, or fake pill. Neither the patients nor the doctors knew who was getting the real prednisone versus the fake. If the patients became pregnant, they continued to take the real or fake medication until they were 12 weeks pregnant. Ultimately, 715 patients were enrolled in the study. 357 received prednisone and 358 received placebo. Because they started the prednisone before the embryo transfer, they could determine first whether prednisone increased the chances for an embryo to implant. However, the results between the two groups were no different. Just over half of the patients had a positive pregnancy test in each group. This is powerful evidence that prednisone does not improve the chance for pregnancy in frozen embryo transfer cycles. Since the medication was continued after pregnancy in those people with a positive pregnancy test, this study could also determine whether prednisone could reduce the risk of very early or later miscarriage. Very early pregnancy losses are known by fertility doctors as biochemical pregnancy losses. These are losses that occurred after a positive pregnancy test, but before a pregnancy could be seen with ultrasound. The results showed that patients who used prednisone actually had a higher risk for a biochemical pregnancy loss. The prednisone group saw 17% of the pregnancies lost after a positive pregnancy test. The placebo group saw only a 10% rate of loss. This was more than just could be attributed to chance alone. For later miscarriages, there was no difference. About 13% of the pregnancies in each group were lost in the first trimester, and around 2% were lost in the second trimester. Ultimately, the percentage of transfers that resulted in a live birth were almost exactly the same. Around 38% of the transfers in each group had a live birth. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: using prednisone in IVF cycles does not improve the chances that you will become pregnant and does not improve the odds that you will have a live birth. If your fertility specialist insists on using prednisone, it's time to get a second opinion. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.